Hi, welcome to week four, lesson number two, or 4B. We're going to focus again on some more trig. As if you can't tell, that's quite a big topic in our pre-cal understanding. So some identities are going to pop up. Just a reminder, these are reciprocal and quotient identities. Take a snippet if you want or Google them for yourself. So let's jump on in. Question 18 has four different questions. So I'm going to break it up into A and B. C and D will be on our next slide. So if I'm given cosecant and secant of a specific trigonometric identity value, then can I find sine, cosine, and then tangent and cotangent? So let's first figure out, using our information on the right-hand side, what I know. So if I want sine, well, looking over here, I know that sine has a reciprocal of cosecant. So I'm going to go ahead and throw down my cosecant information. And since I have cosecant, I can either do 1 divided by this fraction or just remember that that means the reciprocal. So I go ahead and flip it and throw it down. So there's our technical answer. However, if it was a multiple choice and you had to recognize the rationalized form, let me show you what that looks like. So I multiply by the conjugate of the, I multiply by the rationalized form, so I multiply radical by radical to remove it, so there are no radicals in the denominator. So this is rationalization of a radical. A lot of R words, I know. Let's jump one more time to cosine. In cosine with my reciprocal identities, I notice that it is the reciprocal of secant. So 1 over secant, or flipping this fraction right here, should give me my answer. There's my technical answer. However, we know that we like to rationalize, so there's our end answer. If I remember these two answers, that's going to help us with our next question. Of course, I could reset if I needed to. So the next two questions ask about tan and cotan. Or we're going to do a fourth question that has to deal with what's called the cofunction identities, and I'll have a pop-up screen about that. Let's just jump into tan cotan for just a second. If I'm solving tan or cotan, which would just be flipping the answer, then I'm actually not looking at any of my reciprocal identities. I could look at this one right here, cotan tan, but does that help me? The reciprocal between the two tan cotan? That doesn't help me because I only have information about secant and cosecant. So I go down to my quotient identities, and I notice that tan is also equal to the fraction of sine divided by cosine. Well, I can use that. I can either recognize that secant and cosecant are related, so I can flip those and put those in, or go back to the previous slide where we already solved sine and cosine and throw those guys in. And that's what I went ahead and did. Doing some fraction manipulation of my math means actually multiplying by the reciprocal of the denominator, and I end up with just 2/3. Look at that. Tan theta is 2/3. So cotan theta would be 3/2. So you just flip the answer. But look at this funkiness down here. Secant of 90 degrees minus theta. What is that? Well, anytime we basically reflect or translate that theta value, you're dealing with what are called cofunction identities. So here's just a basic snippet, and it's kind of blurry because I stole it from the internet. So you can find this for yourself if you'd like to look on. But if I'm reflecting theta over the 0 over the pi over 4 over pi over 2, you end up with 3 different concepts. And what's really happening is that as you shift your original theta to that other theta, what happens to the positive and negativity or the function itself? So the bigger one that we focus on is this middle value. You can always look at the other two, and I challenge you to look for patterns for yourself. But if you're looking here, if you notice by pi over 2 is a 90 degree. So if I literally shift from one quadrant to the next, what happens? Well, if I take sine and shift it one quadrant, it actually becomes cosine. If I take cosine and shift it one quadrant, it actually becomes sine, so on and so forth, so on and so forth. You can actually check these out, test them for yourself, look at values, consider them. I like messing with pi over 6. So if you look at sine of pi over 6 and then subtract, or really 30 degrees, and then add 90 degrees to that and see what's going on, just keep on moving through, look at some patterns. But we're just going to focus on that secant of pi over 2 or 90 minus theta is equal to cosecant. Well, that's great. So that means I'm just dealing with cosecant. So cosecant theta, that's all we dealt with. That's all a cofunction identity is. Moving on to my, oh, and then of course we solve it because they already gave us cosecant, blah, blah, blah. Moving on to my last question of the day. Well, what happens if they give me one theta and they want to know information about another? We're going to dive into this a little more in another video, but I just want to alert ourselves to this. We are going to go back to what's our right triangle trig. But the most common mistake I see with kids is that they're like, okay, well, if tan is equal to negative 4 over 3, then that means sine must be 4 and cosine must be 3, and boom. Not quite. Tan's quotient identity would be equivalent to sine theta over cosine theta, but that means that when you're looking at this, you're missing the beginning of this fraction. So there are denominators that must have canceled out to end up with negative 4 over 3, but a lot of kids are just going to tell me sine is 4 and cosine is 3. Not quite. It was 4 over something and 3 over something. What was that over something? So you are going to need to give me the right triangle itself. So let's go ahead and go back to our right triangle method and jump on in. So here's a reminder, and it says cofunctions, but the title should be right triangle trig. Here's a reminder of right triangle trig. I go off of our volcano, Sokotoa. So that's what we're going to use. All right, so jumping on in, the first thing I do is I draw my triangle, label it opposite, adjacent, hypotenuse. Since I know tan is opposite over adjacent, I went ahead and labeled my opposite over adjacent. Pause for just a second. I put the negative 4 with the opposite. That's not necessarily always true. What if it was with the adjacent? We don't actually know. I just threw the negative in there. In the end, you're going to have to test your quadrants to figure out your end answer. You're not just going to base it off of, oh, well, the opposite was negative. You don't know. We don't know. So you're going to have to figure that out for yourself, and I'll show you how to do that. Now the next thing I need to do is finish solving my triangle. I need that hypotenuse. So we go to our famous old Greek man. We go to Pythagorean theorem, and we solve for 5. I got really loud there. I know. Sorry. The final thing we do is throw it back into our original Sokotoa. So since we're dealing with cosine, we're dealing with ka. So we end up with 3 over 5. But we're not quite done. That says 5 over 3. It should be 3 over 5. There's a typo. And I think in my answer, there ended up being a typo as well. So that's my mistake. It should be 3 over 5, which is what I wrote here. So just be aware there is a typo alert. But continuing on. So I go to my quadrants, labeling it for all students to take calculus. If I know that tan, let's see that one more time. Sorry. If I know that tan is negative, then I can cross out these two. Sine is negative. I can cross out these two. I'm just left with the fourth quadrant. And I know that my answer must then be positive. And again, I think I wrote 5/3, which would be hypotenuse over adjacent, which is actually secant. So I made a mistake in writing that answer. And for those of you who the animation went a little too fast, let me show that one more time. Sine is negative, so I cross out the 2 where it must have been positive. Tan was negative, so I crossed out the 2 where it must have been positive. Left with my last answer. Boom. That's how I did that. And that's all I've got for you guys. So I'll see you in the next video. Whoa.